Hi, everybody. I'm waiting for Devin to show up, my patient. I've invited her, and she should be here shortly. And we will do our telehealth visit. She messaged me and said she has low back pain. So we're going to go through the exam. I'm going to abbreviate it. Here she is. Hi, Devin.
Hi.
Hey, welcome to our first telehealth visit.
Exciting.
Do you have any trouble logging in?
Nope, super easy.
Great. Perfect. Okay. So Deb, you know that we're recording this and I'm going to use it for a webinar. Is that okay with you?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. Perfect. Okay. So Deb, you reached out to me and let me know that you're having some low back pain. And I last saw you about 3 months ago because you'd been having low back pain. You were doing great at that time. Have you continued doing those exercises from back then?
I'm going to take that as a no.
Yeah. All right. Are you still as active as you were? You were a hiker, climber, skier, I think.
Yeah, totally. So I was like doing the exercises kind of like right after we stopped seeing each other. And then I had like a pretty busy climbing and skiing season this winter and just kind of stopped doing them, but was very active.
Okay. Did you hurt your back then? Did something happen? What kicked it back in?
No, I think it was probably just like the rate of activity. And it started maybe 6-ish weeks ago. And okay. Kind of at like the height of my ski season. I backcountry ski, so there's a lot of like hiking and uphill okay. movement as well.
Okay. And you're not skiing now because all the mountains are closed. I believe all the trails are closed. Yeah. So is it getting better then since you haven't been as active or what's?
No, it's actually not, which is part of the reason why I scheduled this.
Okay. All right. And so you are, as I am, self-isolating at home. So I'm assuming, are you sitting around a little bit more?
Totally. Yeah.
Okay. All right. All right. And when does your back hurt? What makes it hurt?
Time? No. So it is like when I'm sitting around a lot, okay. sitting down and then I get up to do something and my back bothers me. I walk my dog every day and like when we go walking, it hurts. The longer we walk, the more it hurts.
Okay. All right. And then can you make it go away? Is there anything that you can do to make it go away?
Yeah, kind of just changing positions. I can make it go away.
All right. And is it right at your low back? Is that where the pain is?
Mm-hmm. Kind of just in like a band across my low back.
One side more than the other? A
little more on my right.
Okay. And does it go into your butt or down your leg? Mm-mm. Perfect. Are you having any night pain?
No, I mean, if I wake up in the middle of the night, it might be bothering me. And like I said, just like roll over, switch positions. That's fine. It doesn't like keep me up or anything.
Right. Okay. And no change in your health history. Otherwise, you were pretty healthy. You have been very healthy. So,
yeah.
Okay. And no respiratory symptoms. You haven't had COVID.
Nope.
Super great. Healthy. All right. Okay. And you aren't taking any medication. Is that still true?
Correct.
Do you take anything for your back, like ibuprofen or Advil or?
The occasional ibuprofen if it's really bugging me, maybe like after we walk.
Okay. All right. And any changes in your bowel or bladder? Do you pee in your pants or anything? No? Perfect. Good. That's good to know. Okay. So I've covered most of the questions I have for you. So I really want to see you move. Okay. So if you've got space in your room to shift, I think you told me you're going to use a tablet or a surface, right?
Yeah.
So if you can just shift that so I can see, I want to see as much of your body as I can see all the way down to your feet.
Okay. Yeah. Doable.
Oh, wow. Perfect. It needs to get tipped down probably. Great. Oh, that's awesome. Nice view. Can you back up just a tiny bit? Have any more room back there?
Yeah, I do. How's that?
All right, perfect. And then Deb, can you turn sideways to me so you're facing one wall or the other? It doesn't matter which one. Great. And I want you to have you touch your toes for me. Don't bend your knees too much. Bend them a little bit. Great. Come on back up. Does that bother you?
Yeah.
Okay. So what if you do it a few times in a row? Tell me if it gets better, worse, stays the same.
It gets better.
Great. Perfect. Okay. Come on. Put your hands on your hips and I want you to bend backwards for me after you fix your hair.
Hands on my hips?
Yes. And bend backwards. However far you can go. And again, let me know if it bothers you.
Yeah, that bothers me.
Oh, okay. All right. Can you try to, again, do it a couple more times? Let me know if it hurts, but don't go into pain. Is that hurting still?
Yeah.
Okay, great. All right. And then turn around and face me. And I want you to stand on one foot and just balance. Great. Stand on the other one and balance. Perfect. Okay. Now stand on your left leg again, just by itself, and do a little shallow squat. Just stand on one leg and just squat for me like that, up and down. However deep you can go without losing your balance. That looks great. Now to the other side. Okay, so that one doesn't look as good. Are you having a problem doing that?
Yeah, my right knee, that hurts.
Oh, well, you forgot to mention that your right knee hurts. Has your right knee been bothering you too?
It has been, actually. It's kind of been bothering me all of ski season. But I mean, just because I haven't been skiing, I wasn't really thinking about it. I kind of like forgot about it, honestly.
Okay, so was it bothering you before the ski season started?
No.
Okay, so that's been about 3 months or so, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so now I want you to turn sideways again, but I want you to be able to put your hand on the door or the window. You kind of want to make up fingerprints on your window. Perfect. Okay, stand on one foot, and you're going to raise up onto your toes to have as high as you can and go as quickly as you can, about 5 times. Really high every time. Okay, good. Now do the other side. Same thing. Really high. Okay, excellent. Good. All right. And then I know that you do have done yoga, that you do yoga. So I'm going to have you do a side or a forward plank for me. And can you tip the computer, the screen down just a little tiny bit? I can't see quite as low as I want to. Perfect. That does it.
Hold on. I don't want it to close. Yeah. That would be bad. Is that better?
Yeah, I think so. Yes. Yeah. So I'm going to have you do a forward plank sideways to me.
Okay.
Yes. Perfect. Yep. Uh-huh. So just a standard plank, just like that. Yeah. Does that feel okay?
Yeah.
Okay. And then I want you to do something, I call it marching in place, where you lift one foot up and then the other foot up. Try to maintain your plank and just march back and forth like that. And let me know how that feels. is that bothering you?
When I lift my left leg, it does.
Okay. What if you keep your hips a little higher? Go a little higher with your hips. Yeah, which I know is not how you would do a plank normally. And now raise your leg up not so high. Yeah.
That's better.
Okay, perfect. All right. Now I'm going to have you do a side plank. So I want you on your left side first. So, and sideways to me again. Yeah, exactly. So, yep. You might want to move towards your head a little bit. Yeah, great. Okay. So just go up into a side plank and then arm up towards the ceiling. Great. Any problem with that?
No.
Can you raise your right leg up towards the ceiling a few times for me, up and down? Any problem with that?
No.
I wish I could look that good when I did a plank. That's awesome. Great. Okay. Let's have you do it the other direction. So I want your head at the other end. So you're still facing me, and you'll do a plank on your right side. Okay. Just plank for me again. Yeah. Okay. And arm to the ceiling. Great. Does that feel okay?
Yeah.
Okay. And then can you lift that left leg up?
That bugs me.
Okay. That hurts your back?
Yeah.
Not your knee?
No, my back.
Okay. All right. Come on back down again. And then, Deb, I want to see one more thing. As long as you're there, let's do a bridge. So with the bridge, I know you probably know how to do it, but I'm going to explain how I want you to do it. So I'm going to see. Can you see? Let me turn my screen down a little bit. You can actually get into the bridge position, too, if you can still see me. Okay. So we're going to be a lot on your back. Can you see me all right?
Yeah.
Okay. Now lie on your back. I don't want your hands on the ground, okay? So it can be across your shoulders or up towards the ceiling.
Okay.
Just ridge up. You know, kind of high, but not way into an arch. Okay, can you do that for me?
Yeah.
Great. Go a little higher. Okay, good. Does that feel all right?
Yes.
Okay, and then can you march in place? Just like we did with a plank. Yeah, exactly. Any pain with that?
A little bit.
Okay, so I want you to come down just an inch or so. Good. Maybe not even that much. And then I want you to really think about it. When you lift one foot up, don't think about the leg that you're lifting. Push your other foot into the ground. So you're really using your butt to push when you lift your other leg up. Yeah. Don't hold your breath. Does that change it?
It does. Yeah. Wouldn't be like my hips being lower is better.
Okay. Can you feel yourself using your glutes more?
Totally. Yeah.
Okay. Okay. So that's one of the exercises I'm going to have you do. As along with the side planks without the leg lift and the forward plank without the leg lift. And we'll talk some more about it at the end.
Okay.
Okay, I want to see one more thing. And I'm going to, it looks like you have a coffee table, maybe two of them. Can you sit on one? Can you sit on that for me? So and leave the camera, the picture's okay, I think. Okay. Yeah, slide down to the far end of the, yeah, perfect. Okay. So Deb, what I'm going to have you do is sit crummy, probably the way you sit when you have a, in fact, do you use your laptop in your lap by any chance?
Sure do.
In bed when you're watching movies and things, yeah. So that's probably part of the problem too, is that positioning. So okay. When you sit like that, does that bother your low back?
Yeah.
Can you slump a little bit more for me? Bring your chin down to your chest. So don't lean forward, just slump. Yeah, perfect. Okay, so that hurts a little.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now straighten your left leg, stay slumped, and you're gonna kick your left leg out in front of you with your toes up towards the ceiling. Yeah, does that make it worse?
No.
Okay, and then go ahead and set that one down. Keep your chin to your chest and do your right leg with your toes towards the ceiling. Does that make it worse?
No.
Great, good, perfect, okay. So let's have you sit back up. And I want to see one more thing. Do you have stairs in your house?
Yeah.
Can you, I want you to be able to stand on this bottom step if you can show me. Yeah, that's perfect. Wow.
This, and yeah, it should be a perfect little turnaround.
Oh, that's awesome. Great.
Okay.
Perfect. Okay, so stand on that bottom step facing me. Yeah. Great. And then you're going to hang on to the wall or the banister, the railing. Yep. And I want you to do, it's called a step down. You're not actually stepping down. You're going to do like a squat, one-legged squat, and tap your opposite heel on the floor and come right back up to the step. Yeah. Okay. And do one on each side while you're holding on for me. Okay. And I want to see if that, now you're going to, now if you can do it, I want to see if that bugs your knee. You're going to do it without hanging on. So stand on just your left leg and do about three in a row. Just kind of, yeah, and off the ground and come back up. Do a couple more. That looked really good. Just do two more. I want to see what your repetitions are like. Great. Okay, now do your stand on your right leg and do the same thing. Does that hurt?
A little right at the end there.
Okay, all right. Okay, go ahead and come on off. Let's chat about all of this. So sit somewhere. The lighting's better with you. Well, where you were before worked when we started.
My couch. Okay.
When you're against the window, you're a little darker for me.
See? Oh, there's
that. Is that your dog?
Yeah.
What'd she do?
She has a Yeah, she had a little cancer tumor, and when they radiated it, she's fine. When they radiated it, this hair, like, aww, grew back gray.
She's tired. Okay, so Deb, I think that your low back pain is easily fixable. I think you just need to work more on your probably hip and core strength a little bit, and just the symmetry of it. And I think that your back and knee pain are related, not one causing the other necessarily, but if your knee's been bothering you and you skied on a sore knee all season, you already had some prior low back pain, didn't keep up with those exercises, I think just perhaps you've been moving asymmetrically and bothered your back as well. I think the exercises will help both your back and your knee, okay? So today, since we had to do the evaluation, I'm only going to start you on a few exercises, and then I want to do a telehealth visit with you again in a week and go over the ones that you've been doing, see if you're getting any better, and then we'll progress them. In the meantime, the exercises I want you to do at home, like we said, are that bridging exercise. It's really important that you think of pushing that foot down into the ground. Don't think of the leg you're lifting. Think of the leg you're pushing down so you get a better glute engagement. Mm-hmm. And then you're going to do the forward plank. We'll work on time, 30 seconds, working up to a minute or 2 minutes.
Really quick, should I be writing this down or are you going to send it?
Super good question, though. I'm going to put these into that platform I have where I sent you exercises last time.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
I'm going to go into there and I'll modify your exercises. And then you can use the same link I sent you before. And I could also email it to you if you want. You want me to email it to you again and you'll have that link.
Sure. Yeah. That'd be
great. And save it. Save it in a folder that says Devin's exercises or something. Okay. That link won't change. So you can always refer back to that. Even, you know, a year from now, you can refer back to those exercises. So, you'll do the forward plank. We'll work on time. I'm not a fan of just a static plank, but I want you a little bit stronger so you can go back then. Once you can do it for a minute, you can do the marching again. If when you start the marching, it still hurts, but you've been able to do a full minute plank, then I want you to do just like you did before and raise your hips up higher so that you can do the plank without any pain. Once you can do, say, 30 repetitions, leg fairly high, no pain, then you just start bringing your plank back down to a standard plank. Does that make sense, what I'm saying? You know, this is when you're almost in that pike position, right?
Yeah, totally.
And then you'll do the side plank, same thing, 30 seconds, build up to a minute or maybe even 2 minutes. But if you can do a full minute, then I want you to add the leg lift back in. If the leg lift hurts, try shallower, not lifting it so high, or try holding it and not going up and down, whichever way doesn't hurt. And then you'll progress to moving it again 30 times. All right. Mm-hmm. And then we did the bridges, the side plank, the forward plank. Then I'd like you, if you can, to do what's that little mini squat, mm-hmm. but I want you to face a mirror when you do it. Cause when you do that squat, when I was watching you on your right leg, I can see how much it wobbles. So if you can stand in front of a mirror, stand on just your right leg and do that really shallow squat. Don't go into knee pain, but focus on being as stable as you can be without holding your breath. Just think of being really nice and tall and not letting your knee do this and not letting your hips tilt, and just do it to the degree you can do it without pain. Okay. And then hopefully you'll get deeper and deeper to where you can do it off the step like we did today without it hurting. All right.
Yeah.
So that's going to be the exercises we're going to start with. I'm going to email them to you. The other thing I want you to think about is not sitting with your laptop in your lap. Put a pillow on your back when you're sitting. And if your back's bothering you at night, you know, wedge yourself up instead of slumping over your computer. So right, I know I'm not going to probably get your surface away from you watching movies at night or whatever it is that you're doing, talking to friends. We want you to still socially see people. And don't sit for long periods of time. Get up and move around. I didn't go over any stretching today, but like child's pose. And I think you told me when you emailed me that you've been doing some yoga at home, like with a webinar.
Yeah, like every other day.
Yeah. Keep doing that. Work on stretches, do the yoga. If there's a Pilates class online, you could do Pilates also. Just any exercise that bothers you, I want you to modify it so that it doesn't hurt if you can. Okay. Don't do an exercise that recreates your pain. And then at night, if your back is bothering you, I mean, if it's just a little and you can roll over and goes away, no big deal. But if it's bothering you enough, a pillow under your knees when you're on your back or between your knees when you're on your side can help make that go away. And I have an infographic on sleep positions, and I'll just include that in the email for you. Okay. So I know that was pretty quick. Does everything make sense?
Yeah, totally.
Right. Okay. And you can always email me if you get it, you have some questions, just email me and I'll answer them. And then I will see you back in a week for another telehealth visit. You can just message me through the system with another appointment time that works for you.
Okay. Perfect.
Great. All right. Thanks.
Thank you. Great. I appreciate it.
And remember, physically isolate, don't socially isolate.
That's right. Yeah.
Bye.
You know, bye.
And that was our telehealth visit.